Okay, so we're going to shift gears right now, and we're going to jump to a price reduction conversation, because I know right now a lot of listings we take did not sell in 2023, all right? I know that not every listing you took in 2023 sold, and I also know from my personal experience in 2023, I had listings that didn't sell, and I'm also aware that regardless of what happens with interest rates, in a normal market, listings don't sell. In a soft market, even more listings don't sell. In a hot market, some listings still don't sell. So what we're going to demonstrate on stage is an actual price reduction call. And so I am going to be the real estate agent, and you're going to hear exactly what my call to a seller sounds like today. Now, it's going to be over the phone. So how we do that is whenever you're role playing over the phone, You're back to back. Essentially, when you're role playing, you're not looking at your role play partner. And actually, can you take the whiteboard off? I don't need that now. When you role play, you're back to back if it's an over the phone script. Now, I do recommend if you have a listing that's about to expire, and then while you're back there, can you have them bring out my laptop too? I do recommend if you have a listing that's about to expire, doing this in person. Because if you have a listing that's about to expire, you're gonna need to get an extension on the contract, number one. And number two, if I didn't have success selling their house in 60 days or 90 days or whatever it is, you better believe they're already interviewing other agents. So I have to treat this conversation as if it's a new listing appointment. All right, so we're gonna start this role play in a second, but before we do, please join me in welcoming, we have two Glover U coaches that are gonna be the sellers, and they're gonna be on speakerphone, all right? So that's why I asked for two of them to join me. And that's gonna be Miss Jolynn Mersica and Mr. Matt Marsupian. So let's hear it for our sellers. Thank you. Okay, so you guys have a house that's listed at $415,000, and I'm trying to convince you to reduce it to $399,900. It's been on the market for a couple weeks now, and we've had some activity, but absolutely no bites. So one thing I want to make sure everyone knows, and the reason why I asked them to do this, sorry, I'm just organizing my notes so I don't get confused, is I asked them to bring my laptop out here, not because I'm gonna be looking at the MLS, but because anytime you do a price reduction call or a price reduction meeting with a seller, I want you to make sure you always have your laptop open with your MLS in front of you. Never take a call from a seller about, or have a discussion with the seller about their home's value without having your laptop open. It's one of the quickest ways to drive down your credibility with a seller, because when they ask you about a home that sold that you have no idea of, they're going to question whether they should be taking your advice. So you always have your MLS up in front of you. Also, I want to set the stage. When I was at the house, I shared with them the one of three things will happen script. All right, and if you're not familiar with what that is, let's just pretend we were at the kitchen table together. I would say, okay, you heard it. By the way, you've probably heard it in our listing presentation for those of you that have gone through Listing Mastery or Sales Rocket. At the end of the presentation, after I got their listing contract signed, I said, now, Matt, Jolynn, one of three things are gonna happen once we get your home on the market. This is, of course, pretend I'm at the listing table. One of three things is gonna happen once we get your home on the market. We're either gonna get a lot of interest and have a handful of offers, and that means we did everything right. We priced it right. And we marketed it properly, we did all the right things. And by the way, the reason why I always disclose that is because in a softer market, if you sell their home quickly in a soft market, what do they think you did? Do they think you underpriced it? So I'm always planting the seed that if it sells quickly, no, we did the right thing. The second thing I'm telling them before I leave their house is if we have some interest, but maybe no offers at all, that means we're in the ballpark. We might have just started a little too high, a tad too high, and I actually throw out a percentage. I'll actually say, and in my experience, usually about 3 to 5% too high. Worst case scenario, the third thing that could happen is we put it on the market, we see how buyers respond, And we get little to no interest at all, and certainly no offers. And that means we definitely started too high, probably somewhere between 5% and 7% too high based on my experience. I share that. That's the last thing they hear before I leave the table. I guess I do say one more sentence, and I say, now the good news is, Matt, Jolynn, we're going to have a conversation every 10 to 14 days of what took place, and I'm going to give you a recommendation of what we need to do to move forward if your home isn't sold within the first 10 to 14 days. Make sense? Yep, that sounds good. So in other words, I'm planting the seed that in 10 to 14 days, I'm going to call them for our first price reduction, essentially is what I just accomplished there. So let's fast forward. It's been on the market for 14 days, and I'm calling them for a market update. So ring, ring, and you guys are on speaker.
Hello.
You got both of us here.
Oh, awesome. Perfect timing. Actually, let me step out of the role play for a second. So it's not a bad idea to schedule the price reduction call. So I might tell the sellers, you know, I do my market updates with my sellers every Fridays. In fact, in our team for years, Jolynn, you remember this, we had price reduction Fridays because we had to get so many price reductions to get listings to sell. So I let my sellers know I'll be calling you every Friday and or every other Friday. And so before I call them on Thursday in the afternoon when I do my admin work, I'm going to send them an email of all the actives, pendings, and solds since we first listed their house. And I'm gonna do that every 2 weeks. And I'm gonna say, simple one or two sentences, just wanted you to see this before our call tomorrow. Just wanted you to see this before our call tomorrow. So that way, they have a visual, okay? Because I might actually ask them to pull it up. And usually, by the way, by the time I call them, they've looked at it. All right, so let's jump into the role play. Ring, ring.
Hello.
Hey, Matt, this is Jeff Glover here, just calling for our bi-weekly market update. Do you have a few minutes for me?
Yeah, I do. My wife Jolynn's right here with us.
Oh, okay, perfect.
Hi, I'm here.
Well, you guys are married now. I didn't know that. That's great.
Yeah. we're the grand fluencers.
There we go. Yeah, I love that. There really. We go. All right. So since we last listed the house, it's been about 14 days, as you know. We've had three showings and we've got some feedback. And we sent you that one feedback. What did you think about it?
I don't remember what it said. Could you refresh our memory?
Yeah, they just thought that the backyard was too small for the price. They were looking for a little bit of a bigger backyard.
Yeah, well, it only takes one, right?
Yeah.
I guess it wasn't the house for them.
Yeah, no, you're right. It only takes one. You're absolutely right about that. And it might not have been the house for them. And speaking of the house for them, I do want to let you know, since we last spoke in the market, I did a 1 square mile radius around your house, as I promised I would. We've had one new listing. Two listings actually go pending and one closing within 1 square mile within the last 10 to 14 days. Now, here's something you should know. The new listing that came on the market is a competitor to us. They weren't on the market before when we listed. It's very similar. It's over on Orange Avenue and they just listed for $399,900. Are you familiar with that house?
No, we haven't seen that yet.
Yeah, so I sent you a link yesterday afternoon with these. Would you guys take a second and maybe just pull that up on your phone really quick?
You looked.
This is I pulled it up and glanced through it. I saw the sign pop up, but I didn't really spend a lot of time looking at the interior photos.
That's fine. So I did have a chance to go through them, and if you want to pull them up and take a look at it again, you're more than welcome to. That's a nice place for $399,900, and if I was a buyer right now, and I had two homes to choose from, yours at 415 or this one over at 399, it'd be really tough for me to go after a house at 415. So that is definitely a competitor to us and one that might affect our sale.
Jeff, do they have all the same updates that we have?
Yeah, so I went through yep. So here's what I noticed. Obviously, you guys have a finished walkout lower level. They do not, all right? They have a walkout lower level, but it is not finished. However, they do have a much larger property. They've got a double lot, so they're on an acre versus a half acre. And there's a lot of buyers who would say, you know what, we can always finish a lower level. We can't add more land unless the neighbors want to sell to us. So that ends up being a wash in some cases. Does that make sense?
Yeah, so what do you think's wrong with that house? Why would they come in at such a low price?
Well,
like they're killing our value.
Yeah, so I think what happened is... they obviously had a market analysis done by an agent, and their agent and them decided based on listings and sales that $399,900 was probably a price to beat us. I mean, in true transparency, they probably want to sell before you guys want to sell. So we're not going to let that happen, okay?
Yeah, I guess, our hesitation is just it's only been on the market for 14 days, and we have had a few showings. I know that one person wasn't interested, but, I can't help but think that, we just have to wait a little bit longer.
Yeah.
And how many days did the other two that went pending spend on the market before they went pending?
Yeah, great question. So one of them was on the market for 11 days, and the other one was on the market for 9 days. So the reason why I'm reaching out to you today, you may remember, we covered the one of three things that will happen, and we're in a spot where we got some interest, but we didn't get any offers. And I'm concerned your listing might get stale if we don't make any adjustments soon. Now, let me ask you, are you familiar with the term days on market is the enemy to your home's value?
Actually, we heard you say that, and I was wondering, what is the average day on market in our market currently?
Yeah, so days on market is the enemy is essentially based on the premise that when you, like for instance, when you bought this house, you had some questions to your agent when you were making an offer of, you know, what's the condition of the roof? How are the schools? You know, the condition of the furnace. Did you at all ask the seller or the seller's agent, or were you at all concerned as to how long the home had been on the market?
Yeah, I think we had kind of wanted to know how long it had been sitting because we were debating, you know, what we were going to make an offer for.
Yeah. So if it had been on the market for a long time, then you might be able to get a better what?
Yes, but I think the difference then was we bought in what would be considered a down market where homes were sitting on the market, and now everything seems to be moving so quickly. So I think it, you know, it's a little different.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, no, you're certainly right. When you bought then, the market was a little slower, so you probably got a better deal, which is, you know, kudos to you. You're gonna do pretty well on this house. And regardless of what market we're in, Jolynn, Matt, if it's a hot market, a soft market, a normal market, the longer a home is on the market, the less it's worth, period. I mean, that rule's been around in the industry for decades. The longer a home is on the market, the less it is worth. And so it's my job as your agent to be upfront and honest with you and tell you the truth of what I think it's going to take to get your home sold. You do want the truth, don't you?
We do, and I remember when you kind of walked through the house, we discussed replacing some carpet and maybe painting, and we decided not to do that, knowing that that could be a negotiation tactic. I mean, what if we offered some sort of like credit, or you called the other two people that have viewed the home that hadn't given feedback and maybe said, hey, we could offer to do that for them?
Yeah. Well, unfortunately, it's my estimation that the people that did look at your house, because we have reached out for feedback, and we do now see two new pendings similar to your homes, my guess is they're already gone. And so at this point, we're doing everything we can to drive new traffic into your house. And in order to do that, I'm going to go ahead and recommend at this time, I don't want your listing to become stale. We're going to need to get it below that $400,000 level to convince a buyer out there to buy your home versus the competition, especially that one that just came on the market. So if you're okay with it, I'd like to go ahead and get that taken care of. First thing tomorrow morning, we're going to get it blasted out to everyone in the market so they know of the new price. And can I tell you what's really great about getting it under $400,000, guys?
Sure.
We open it up to a whole new pool of buyers. Buyers that didn't even know that your home was for sale because they were capping their search at $400,000.
Jeff, I hear what you're saying, and I get it to get it under that $400,000, but $15,000 is a lot of money to go after only being on the market for 14 days. I mean, doesn't it make sense to maybe do $3,000 or $5,000?
That's what I was thinking. What about $5,000 and you host two open houses this weekend?
Yeah.
410.
Yeah. Yeah. That sounds great.
You said drive traffic. Let's drive it.
Yeah, no, that sounds great. I really have nothing going on, so there's nothing I'd love to do more. Kidding. Well, Jolynn, Matt, we could certainly consider that, absolutely. And my fear is that as we do that, we're only driving up the days on market counter. Now, here's what I'll tell you, and here's what I know about the market right now. A home will sell for what it's worth, no matter what you price it at. A home will sell for what it's worth, no matter what you price it at. So if you're comfortable with 405 or 410, which it sounds like you guys would be, is that right? If I had a buyer at 405?
I think we could split the difference at, say, 407.5, and then, you know, who knows? There may be something wrong with that other house that we don't know about, and
fair.
We would be shortcutting our value.
Understood. So if we had a buyer right now at 407.5, you would take it, is that right?
After being on the market with no offers for 2 weeks, I mean, it's not ideal, but probably, yeah.
Yeah, it's only 2 weeks.
Yeah. All right, so then let's do this. We're going to go ahead and get the price to $399.9. We're going to hold firm at that price. And here's why I'm going to do that. because once we get below the $400,000 level, there's a real good chance, of course you guys know I can't promise this, but there's a real good chance because we're opening it up to a whole new pool of buyers. And listen, I know the Plymouth market very well. When I look at what's sitting and what's selling, everything below $400,000 is selling like hotcakes. So I know we're gonna get a lot more eyeballs on your property and potentially put yourself in a multiple offer situation if we get it to the $399,900 price. Now here's the deal. If we drop it to that price and you're not comfortable with the offers that we receive, you can always tell them no. But if your goal is to get a number with a four in front of it, you have a better chance of doing that at $399,900 than you do at $407,500. Does that make sense?
It does, but I have a question. What if the home that just came on the market goes pending and then we're the only home on the market at $407,500?
Yeah, well, and that's a great question, Jolynn. And of course, I study homes and prices every day, and there are kind of unique situations where that might be a small window of opportunity to get your home sold to a buyer because it's the only one in the neighborhood, let's just say. And here's what I know. There's a new home between $350,000 and $450,000. There's a new home that comes on the market every 3 to 4 days. And so if it's not that one, it's going to be the next one. So what I really think is best, and you know, you hired me to be honest and upfront with you, and I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't tell you the truth. We really need to get it to that $399,900 level. And based on what I'm seeing, this hopefully will be the only time we have to have this conversation. And our next call is me coming to you with two or three buyers saying they want to give you more than $400,000. Does that sound good?
Let me throw one more thing at you.
Sure.
Let's pretend we just take it off the market and we spend a couple grand doing the paint and the carpet and the things, and we take new photos, right? Yeah. And then we put it back on the market at $415,000.
Yeah. We could certainly do that, Matt. That is absolutely an option. I mean, buyers buy based on value. And what I would caution you with that is you told me when we listed the home for sale that your goal was to get out to Phoenix. And you've got family there and they're waiting for you. So have you calculated, or what you might want to consider calculating is the time it's going to take to do the work, the money it's going to take to do the work, and then of course now the volatility of the market. Guys, if prices come down, like we're seeing a lot of possibilities of that happening, we might not be talking, $399,900 might look attractive because we might be talking at about a number of $385,000 or even $380,000 at that point.
I mean, we can have carpet and paint done within 2 weeks. We've got great contractors, but
yeah,
you know, I don't know.
I mean, if we're going to have to lower it even more, I'd be...
Yeah.
No one even complained about price.
Yeah.
They just said the backyard was too small.
Well, so, understood. And you're right. They did not complain about price. I don't have anything in writing saying that somebody complained about price. And here's what I know. If a home is on the market and it's not getting showings and it's not getting offers, that is buyers complaining that they don't see enough value in your home to come and take a look at it.
What about the fact that it's -3 degrees here in Michigan right now?
Yeah, so definitely, you know, it's cold. And I'm still working every day. It's cold and I'm working every day to help obviously get your home sold. And here's what I know. We have less competition than we have right now. And that's my fear. If you wait and do this work and things start warming up, I mean, we're worried about one or two competitors. By the time you get everything done, we might have three or four competitors. So, again, I wouldn't be. It is, you guys hired me to tell you the truth, and at the end of the day, it's your house. You're going to do what you want with it, and even if you tell me no, Jeff, let's keep it at 415. I'm still going to fight to try to get you 415. And I also know that I'd be doing you a disservice if I let you keep it on the market at this price any longer.
Yeah, I get what you're saying, and I think it makes a lot of sense. I think my biggest fear, honestly, to go to $399,900 is to that someone's going to come in and see that we've lowered the price 15 and they're going to offer us $385,000.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if we do take your advice and we do list it at $399,900 and we don't get any offers, I mean, you know, can we take it off the market or reevaluate at that time?
Absolutely. I mean, I'm going to give you all the options at that time. And if I'm in your shoes, I would want to know, all right, how are buyers going to respond at $399,900? And by the way, Matt, Jolynn, there's a chance that we go to $399,900 and the buyers could speak again and say, we still don't think it's worth $399,900. Now, I don't think that's going to be the case based on what I'm seeing. But if that ends up happening and we have this conversation 2 weeks from now and I'm suggesting maybe $385,000 or a number that's not attractive to you and a number that's not worth it, then yes, we would have the conversation about just pulling the home from the market, because I don't want to waste your time, and of course I don't want to waste mine.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we have a bottom line to meet in order to move on to our next venture. So I think I'm in the same boat of being afraid that people will come in with the same complaints. So, you know, we started where we did, so we had a little room to negotiate.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Jeff, $399.99 or $400, does it make a difference?
Well, actually, what I want you to tell me is, no, we think we want to give it another couple weeks at $415.
Yeah, we want to give it a couple more weeks at $415.
Yeah, okay.
Maybe we'll do some cleaning up. I'll make sure the backyard looks good, trim some bushes and some hedges.
Yeah,
and okay. You know, it's only been 14 days.
Yeah.
Kids can come over and paint. It's fine.
Yeah, totally appreciate that. And again, you hired me to sell your house and to tell you the truth. And what I would recommend, if it's okay with you, it is this big of a deal to me. I want you guys to take the night to sleep on it. Because my gut is telling me if we do that, you're not going to like the position that we're in 2 weeks from now. And so why don't you guys, you know, have a conversation tonight, have a glass of wine, do whatever, and we'll talk in the morning, and you'll tell me to go ahead at $399.99, let's do it, or let's keep it at $415 for another couple weeks. But I really do feel like I'd be doing you a disservice if I didn't ask you to give it some sincere thought. Does that sound fair?
Yeah, I think that's fair. And we'll take a look more deeper at the email that you sent over. Perfect. And all the photos of the listings and kind of get back with you in the morning, if that's okay.
That sounds perfect. Okay, so I'm going to stop the role play right there because, by the way, that's all right. Thank you. 99 times out of 100, I'm going to get a text within an hour. All right, just go ahead and drop it. Just go ahead and get it to $399.99 or a call in the morning. Go ahead and drop it. And so I wanted to demonstrate that because that was very real. And you might be wondering, did you have scripts in front of you? No, I actually just had the stats on the house in front of me. I was looking down because I was pretending as if I was on the phone with them with my headset on and looking at the MLS. So those were all real objections, all real concerns. And as you are preparing for your next price reduction meeting, because by the way, if it were a meeting, I'd have comps that I'm actually showing them. Otherwise, the conversation would be exactly the same. Or price reduction call appointment, because it really should be scheduled. Otherwise, you know, they could call you back while you're in the car. That's a very typical process. Now, before we head to our last segment of today, while I have you guys here on stage, what did that feel like from your side? Like, what were your kind of takeaways from that?
Well, number one, you were prepared. Like you said, you were in front of a computer. You were looking at things. You weren't in the car on the go. I didn't hear background noise. You know, you were focused on what you were talking about. You had that information in front of you. And then the second thing for me, at least, is you didn't argue with anything I said. You didn't say but. You didn't try to defend yourself.
Yep.
You made us feel as though our concerns or our objections were valid.
And you knew what kind of questions we would be asking. How many days are homes sitting on the market?
Yep.
What does, you know, our competition actually look like? So that preparation on top of, you know, just having the comps in front of us.
Yep.
Super helpful because it gave us a dead end road.
Yeah.
We didn't have any other questions
to ask.
We didn't have anything to disprove.
You have nowhere to go because that's what ends up happening. Well, what about that one over here? Yep. I got that one in front of me.
It's helpful when there aren't a lot of comps because we can't argue with things.
That's right. Did you also feel that I was respectfully firm with you?
Absolutely.
Did you guys feel that as well?
Yeah.
Respectfully firm. And so I think it's important when you're doing your price reduction conversations that comes across as you're the expert. You know, and you heard me say, and by the way, that's how you soften the blow when you have to say something tough. I wouldn't be doing my job if. I would be doing you a disservice if. Get used to saying that when you're on price reduction calls, because that's where they're like, oh, darn. Okay, he means business with this conversation. Every single time you have a conversation with a seller about price, it should look and feel very similar to that. Those were all real objections. And many of you already caught some of the handlers I use because you've been through Sales Rocket or Listing Mastery, but it's just no different than writing a listing appointment script or a buyer consultation script, which... Buyer Business Accelerator, Nick Belmore, he'll do a good job of that with you. It's no different than writing any other script. It's now you're writing out a price reduction script every day. You want to get good at that conversation Every single day, you should write out a price reduction script that just took place in the state.
We've all had those sellers that suddenly decide that they could take it off the market and be okay. You went back to the motivation.
Yeah.
The motivation was the key. And I think those conversations, it's key to do that because you want to get somewhere. You want to do something. You want to sell. You're not doing all this for fun.
Yeah, that's right. And by the way, price reduction calls are not fun. It wasn't intentional that I was like kind of sad making that call. They're not fun. They're not high energy smiles. I mean, they are very tough calls. I mean, you are calling someone and essentially saying, we got it wrong. And I know that, you know, sometimes you maybe want to avoid those. And I can tell you a lot of your competitors avoid those because that's how they end up with an expired listing, because they're not willing to have that tough conversation. But if you want to be a strong listing agent, that is absolutely a skill that you're going to want to get good at in not only helping you take more listings at the right price, because by the way, a lot of that dialogue I would use at the listing table, because of course there sometimes is some of this at the listing table, as you've heard, you know, when we do our listing presentation, but that exact dialogue I use at the table or over the phone when I'm trying to get a reduction. So did you guys get some value from that? Awesome. Okay. All right. Let's thank our sellers, Matt and Jolynn. Thank you guys.